didn't.
Okay, so Alchemist in 3. Sorry, what is it? 3.4?
3.6.
3.6. Alchemist in 3.6K is pretty decent to play because nobody's really going to contest you that much. Let's
Yeah.
look at your team first off. You've got, well, let's look at Alchemist against this enemy team. So you've got a Tinker mid who is actually pretty hard to play against
Yeah.
as an Alchemist. So that's a bit rough. At the same time, you've got a pretty farm intensive. Well, Slark is decent against Alchemist as well because Slark comes online way earlier than Alchemist. Let's say about 13, 14, 15 minutes in, Slark will have his. Let's see, when did this guy. Okay, there you go. 15, 16 minutes in. 15 minutes in, he's got the Shadow Blade, and then he can just keep ganking you constantly. In 21 minutes in, he's got the Echo Saber as well. So he's going to come online pretty quickly. Void is again pretty decent core against Alchemist, and so is this guy because he puts up his vault, and then your Radiance is gonna harm your entire team. And Pudge is
Yeah.
pretty damn good against Alchemist as well because Pudge is a hero who's gonna pressure the lanes really early on. He hooks you, you're dead before you're level 6, and even after you're level 6, if they've got pretty much Tinker, well, Pub, 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 Pudge is gonna hook you near Tinker, and then he's going to rot you. You're not going to be able to escape. Even if you have ultimate, the burst from Tinker is way too much, and you're pretty much dead.
Yeah.
So, very rough game for Alchemist, but let's jump into it and see how you played against that. Now, if I was you, my goal here would be seeing it. Well, first of all, you need to see if you're going to get how much pressure you're going to get on your lane and how much your team is going to support you. Now, in a high level game, you're definitely going to be ganked a lot, so there is no other choice than to go for a armlet, right?
Yeah.
But the thing is, like in your games, people, first of all, people don't really know that they should pressure. Secondly, they don't know how to pressure. They're most likely going to come and pressure and then feed themselves. So it's a case of you have to figure out if this game is a game where you need armlet, or whether you
Yeah.
can be super greedy and actually just rush the Radiance. So when you want to rush the Radiance, you just have brown boots, a bottle, a few, like some stats from Ironwood Branch, or maybe not, I don't know, and that's it. And then
Yeah.
you get go for the Radiance rush, and you get the Radiance by 8, 9, 10 minutes, maximum 10 minutes.
Cool.
With the armlet, you're going to still get the Radiance pretty quickly. It's going to be like 14, 15 minutes in, but the thing is that in this game, 15 minutes in, if you get armlet and Radiance, Slark is going to be online by that time, and he's going to completely wreck you. Whereas if
Yeah.
you have Radiance by 8, 9 minutes, then you have travels as well, and then Slark is going to have a really hard time because every time you're farming and whatnot, you're going to make sure you're full HP all the time, and every time you see Slark, you just keep away. They
Yeah.
don't have too much lockdown apart from the Pudge, so really Slark will have to. I forgot to mention. Yeah, you're going to be constantly, as soon as you have Radiance, you're not going to show anywhere in lane. You're just constantly going to be farming in the jungle. You're going to look
Okay.
to get your Manta as quickly as possible. In fact, I would even go for Manta before travels just because you need the Manta so urgently. And
Okay.
every time Slark comes into the jungle to kill you, you just TP away.
Yeah.
So not travels TP, but regular TP. And he will have to come with Pudge or with Void to really be able to kill you or lock you down or something. But if you see Pudge off the map, then you know that's like
30
that's the
seconds
time
to
that you
go.
want to just stay near your tower. Now the other thing
Yeah.
is, like looking at your team, let's have a quick look at when people pick what, because your pick is completely out of this draft is completely weird. Nothing fits in. Enemy
Don't think
draft
people
is
consider
kind
what
of
they're gonna play at
okay, so
this level.
you picked Alchemist after these two guys, so that's pretty decent. Timber is also decent, so it's the Drow Ranger who was just picked randomly, so that's doesn't make any sense why the guy would pick Drow here, but you know, oh well.
Everybody gets it.
What are you gonna do? Now against the Tinker,
Receive
let's
the
see, what did you go for? So you've got a set of tangos, Culling Blade, Stout Shield, and these things. So Culling Blade, in my opinion, against a Tinker is pretty useless, as you are not really going to be he's going to be lasering you. That means you are not going to be hitting, right-clicking. And then he's going to lay down the march of the machine, so there's no way you're going to go close to the creeps to be able to farm. So, to be honest, the Culling Blade is kind of useless here.
Yeah.
Yes, this guy has pretty... So, his right-click damage isn't that bad, but the animation is horrible. I find it so hard to last it, but this guy is actually horrible. But the thing is that you are actually not going to be able to last it that well anyway. So, what you should have gone for is... I'm going to talk about this a little bit. So what you should have gone for is maybe just rush the bottle, really.
Yeah.
Just leave this Culling Blade. I don't know how I feel about the Iron Branches, because if you're rushing the bottle, then what you... Okay, so what you could have done is you could have had a Stout Shield, two branches, left out the Tangos, and asked your team for Tangos. That way you've got, 325 gold in the bank. You literally get a rune. And that's it. That's your bottle. Or you could have left the branches out and just gone for a set of Tangos, which essentially means the same thing. So I don't know. Either way, it's pretty okay. I guess branches is better because it gives you some more HP and some right click. So I guess branches is better, and then get cool Tangos. Get this. You got the bottle. And that's it. You're fine. And then you keep farming with the acid spray and try to last it if you can. Now... normally, I would say rune cut test is not a good idea, but with an alchemist, it's just, you have to. So,
yeah.
Did you get the rune?
No.
Oh, that's sad.
Yeah.
Do you know about? Let me just check if you were doing it or not. Do you know about the constant right click spam? Looks like you were doing that. You have that option in the settings.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. Wait. So what was that? Sorry.
There's an option in the settings that you can have, which is auto repeat right move. Yeah.
Oh.
So if you've got this selected, then you don't actually need to spam break your mouse. You can just click it, right click once, and it automatically, forces it constantly right click. So you can actually
I'll turn it on straight away.
Yeah, you can actually take the rune that way. So creep aggro, that's decent. Yeah, that's what I mean. Like, wow, he could have lasered you and then gone for the right pick, because that makes a bit more sense. But then he doesn't have anybody contesting, and so yeah, you just pull the creep aggro every single time. Do not acid spray here. This doesn't help you. It's already now you acid spray. No. Yeah, so you've got some decent timing, but a good understanding of lane equilibrium, decent understanding. Creep aggro. Okay. So what you could have done right here, let's look at this. 20 seconds ago. So, you're low on HP, and there's creeps over here. Makes sense that you want to go and eat the Tango, but the thing is that you're actually going to lose this. You've got three creeps right here. Right? You've got three creeps here. This creep is about to die, which you want to take the last hit off. And the Tinker is coming, going aggressive on you, but you've got three creeps, and he's under your Acid Spray. Right?
Yeah.
So... there's two. These are two reasons for you to go and attack him. You're gonna have the better creep damage on him. You're actually not even gonna take damage from this creep. So literally, the only damage you're gonna take is from his right clicks and then his laser that he probably has coming off cooldown very, very soon. So there's no way you're gonna die. And you wanna eat a Tango, but you would have had to go all the way back here. So what you should have done is right around this point right here. You could have planted a tree and eaten that tree.
Yeah,
this was the time for you to plant a tree and eat the tree. Or you could have taken this last hit and now gone all the way back, eat the tree, then come back, because then you wouldn't have missed the last hit. You could have actually, right here, you could have actually killed Tinker if you'd gone on him. But you missed the XP for that range field.
Yeah,
as well,
I did.
But
yeah.
That's, Just a little bit of heads up there. Even now, you're low on HP, and you're not eating a tango, which makes sense that you don't want to go all the way back to the trees, but you can plant a tree, so.
Yeah, it's a good idea, that. I just didn't.
I mean, I think I just said that you might die here.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, this when you went for this last hit is when I said you still got three tangos. You never ate a tango. Like now you eat a tango, but I think he has a high ground board. Yeah, he has a high ground board, and that's how he saw
you.
Yeah,
it is. Yeah.
That's a very good ward as well, like, there's no way that ward was going to get dewarded, so the support player on that team knew what he was doing. Really rough time to die for you as well, because you almost had bottle. You actually had, I think you might have had bottle, you just didn't click it.
I think I had like 6-8, 5-8 when I died or something like that. I just didn't have enough.
6-16, oh my god.
10 gold off.
Less than 10 even. Alright. That's rough.
Yeah.
Yeah, this could be. Didn't really need that. So this is what I mean, like, you're not really right-clicking anything down that much. You do need Culling Blade later on, but as starting items, I don't think Culling Blade. Like, you don't have Culling Blade after your... Because you need bottle to keep your HP and mana up because of all this ticker spam. And he's not even... I think he's going for the... Okay. I don't know. He's got 2 points. Why did he even get a March point? So it doesn't make any sense at all. Let's see what we level up. 5.
So I went.
Yeah.
Naked Radiance because I thought. Okay. Like I'm not having a good time in lane, but I'm also like not getting ganked or anything, so I didn't feel like I needed the survivability of the armor. Right.
Let's go back here. And this is something that you should have been doing from the very beginning.
Okay.
Whether or not you have a hard lane or a regular lane, unless you have a super, super easy, actually, even if you have a super easy lane, at all times with an alchemist, you want to be stacking yourself.
Yeah.
You can stack yourself. And let me show you right here when you, so the first wave, you acid spray, and you right click it down if you can. Regardless, it's gonna go in. It's gonna get pushed out pretty quickly. You got all four losses as well. That's good. So right now, it's the second wave is coming in. It's around here. Your wave is pretty much under tower, which means this wave is gonna die fairly quickly. But the other wave is gonna stand here for a few seconds. It's gonna wait around here for a few seconds, and by that time, this wave is gonna be pretty much at the high ground, which means that this wave might get shot down by the tower as well, which means that this wave is going to eventually... Well, we'll see when we get there, but right here, you should have gone up to... instead of just walking around in this area, you should have gone up here to this creep camp and stacked it at 53. Okay. You stack it at 53, and then you come back to the lane. That way, maybe you miss one CS. Right?
Yeah.
You need to memorize how long it takes you to get from this here to stack. In fact, with an alchemist, because you will have acid spray, you can actually stand somewhere around here and throw down the acid spray. So literally, it's like 5 seconds for you to get till here to throw down acid spray, and it's about 7 seconds on the dire, and it's about 6 to 7 seconds on the radiant if you have boots, which alchemist does always frequently have boots. So you really should have stacked that. And actually, if you see the scenario here, this is when you would have been stacking. And actually, this creep is dying. This creep is dying quicker because you laid down acid spray. Actually, let's go back and see before you creep down acid spray. So 45. So you would be Okay. So 2 seconds later, you would be stacking, and these guys are at full HP. And this guy, no way this guy dies, because the marsh is laying down, is going down.
Yeah, yeah.
And so maybe that guy had died. I don't know. By this time, and by this time, you would have been back here. And then you could have taken 3 of the CSs minimum, and maybe 4.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. And you want to do, ideally, you want to do a similar thing when it comes to the rune time. But I think when it's the rune time, I like to stack this one here and this one here if I'm radiant. So that you just, you stand around here, you throw down the acid spray, and then you walk here. You will be there before the 0-0. And in this case, you're standing around here, you throw down the acid spray, they'll start moving on this direction, and then you just go and grab the rune.
I didn't even think about using acid spray to stack. That's a
yeah.
good idea.
No way. You just need to make sure you don't use acid spray for the second wave, you know, so that you have the acid spray off cooldown. So it's
yeah.
kind of like close timing. But it's something that you, if you're going to play, let's see how much Alchemist. If you're going to play Alchemist a lot, yeah, you play, well, not that much. But if you play Alchemist a lot, if you want to learn Alchemist really well, then that's something that you, there you go. That's what you're doing right now. Obviously, now the only issue is that you're not going to get the rune in time.
Yeah.
And if somebody's already waiting at the rune, then they're going to grab it before you. So that's
yeah.
the only. So you're going to be 3 seconds late.
Yeah, I think I get it, but that's just luck. Like, someone could have been waiting for that.
Yeah.
yeah.
In fact, there's a kill here that you missed up, Tinker.
I didn't want to dive the tower for that one. I was a bit
okay.
scared. I think I play very scared in lane. That's one of my problems.
It's fine. It's fine. Something that
okay.
has to be done. Then Alchemist, it's okay, because you're really weak. Okay. Once again, here, the creeps weren't about to die, and you threw down the acid spray, and you lost one CS. Right
yeah.
now, you could have gone up there, right-clicked the range creep, killed it, and then right-clicked the melee creep, killed it. You didn't need acid spray. You don't need to push out the lane. You don't need to push out the lane right now too quickly, because you're going to get to the next wave in time to take the... To stack and then come back, and then you can acid spray or use acid spray to stack, whatever. Either way,
yeah.
So, okay.
Okay.
Looks like void. Oh my god.
We got the
and
kill.
It's okay. So, main point is. Number one, better starting items. Two, always stack. Another thing is, if you are going to go for a armlet, then another place that you can stack is the what are they called?
Ancients.
Yeah, ancients.
Yeah.
You don't actually need to go anywhere. You just stand here and throw down the acid spray, and they will stack. And while they're
yeah.
stacking, they will also get damaged, and you'll be getting some like passive gold. And once you have armlet, then you can go and clear them. Ask one of your supports or somebody to come and take the mid XP farm, and you can go and take the stacks once you have the armlet, which isn't gonna get you the radiance any faster. But once you have the radiance, it's gonna. Okay, so you're still gonna have radiance at 14 minutes. It's just that if you don't take the ancient stack, you're gonna get radiance and then 0 gold. While if you're taking the ancient stack, you're gonna have radiance and 1500 gold.
Yeah, yeah.
The point being that you're gonna get the radiance while taking the ancient stack. It's okay. Yes, I mean, see, you missed out. So, I know what you did here, that you wanted to get some CS from the essence spray, but you always have to keep in mind how is the creep equilibrium going to shift. Because, look, all these 4 creeps are alive. And because this
yeah.
march of the machines is down, you don't know what level it is. You're probably thinking it's, what level is Tinker? Tinker is level 7. It should be 4 levels, but it's 3, so it's fine. But it's going to, regardless, kill these creeps really, really quickly. So what
yeah.
you could have done is taken this rune and then tried to get to the lane as quickly as possible. And that way, you could have gotten, at the very least, the XP for all 4
yeah,
creeps.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah.
and then maybe two or three CS. But you see, when you move like this, then you don't stack, you don't get the creeps in the middle, you don't get even the XP, so you're literally just wasting time. So that's not...
Yeah.
Yeah, like single creeps is not useful. This is not something that you want to be doing ever. You got an assist for that, but you don't want to be taking part in team fights at all.
Okay.
You don't get as much gold from... You get more gold from a creep camp than you do from an assist or a kill. Unless it's a kill on somebody with a streak. That's a different story. Because 15 seconds, 20 seconds roughly, you got your last CS at 38. So 22 seconds, you were at 2300 gold. And you got barely 50 gold for this assist. Assume you get 50 gold for this assist. So you got 50 gold, not even 50, you got 30-ish gold for this assist. So in total, I'll be generous, you got 100 gold max from these two. 100 gold you get from 2 CS. You get more than 100 gold for 2 CS as a greenful speed. So, yeah. And also the bigger issue is not the gold, it's that you actually risk dying. That's the bigger issue.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. I mess this up so badly.
Yeah.
Two down.
Yeah. I think the bigger issue is that. The bigger issue is that they're not stacked, so it's really not that beneficial. Yeah. And then the other thing is, it took you 40 seconds to take these two camps. Literally, if you'd thrown down the acid spray, killed this camp, then gone over here, killed this camp, I think you might have been 5 seconds earlier.
Yeah.
And then you would have been in time to stack this camp, maybe. So.
Just embarrassing.
You want to throw the acid spray, like, here.
Yeah.
And maybe eat a few more trees, actually. But yeah, the lane was free. You should have taken the lane farm first. Then nobody's really ganking you. The Pudge isn't ganking you. Pudge isn't ganked you at all throughout the game. So, yeah, you should have been more focused on the lane. Once again, you're doing the same thing. You're going in for kills and whatnot. Not really. Sure. Yeah, this is lucky. Creeps at the lucky. Bit of waste of the haste rune. Now you could have used the haste rune to get to the mid lane quicker and acid spray this, then try to get the rune really quickly. Radiant mid tower. Just there now. Jungle. Stack the jungle. Oh god, you're not even. Stack it. You can stack it. That's good. Okay, this time decide to stay here.
How about that?
There's some small inefficiencies. I would recommend that you go and watch any high-level player playing Alchemist and just watch the first 15 minutes of their game. Watch like 3 or 4 of them from player's perspective. Watch Miracle, watch Midwan, watch Super.
Yeah.
Watch these guys just for 15 minutes. First 15 minutes, what they do, how they do. Just pause the game, try to understand what they're seeing on the map, what their decision-making is, why they're going where they're going, when do they stack, when do they not stack. Why do they do what they do? So you need to watch it very, very closely. And just try to see when they're taking part in team fights, when they're not taking part in team fights, what they're seeing. These are all very important things, because you're being part of team fights, but that's not what Alchemist should do. You're very similar, your playstyle is very similar to mine, and that's why I don't play Alchemist, because when I see a team fight, I want to contribute a little bit, you know. Play safe, but contribute a little bit. You are playing safe, you're contributing a little bit, that's not what you want to be doing with an Alchemist, unfortunately.
Yeah, yeah.
So this is not a hero for you, unless you want to change your playstyle considerably.
Okay.
Yeah, so this is what's gonna happen if you don't stay off the map, stay close to where you have vision. Unfortunately, you have no vision right now. Like, this is a lane board. This is sort of a lane board. This entire map is black.
Yeah.
So you can't really go anywhere safely. And as we said earlier, I think it was a combination of Slark plus Pudge that you died here too. Yeah, it is Pudge. Locked you down and then Snark killed you.
Yeah.
So that's what the issue is. That's what we spoke about earlier. Snark is gonna find you and Pudge is gonna kill you, but it was the other way around.
Yeah.
I mean, it's the same thing. They're both roaming together and killing people, so it's gonna make your life really hard. This is why you need to rush the man. Nice. And she's still dead. Bad timing. So, based on the map right now, if I was you, I definitely would have TP'd here and gone to the jungle.
Yeah.
Because everywhere else, people are taking the farm. So let's see where you decide to go. You decide to go bot. Fortunately, bot has no vision. And they have the tower there, so multiple people can TP there. You're going to be farming right underneath the tower. You don't want to be pushing towers as an AL. You don't care about towers. You don't care about lanes pushing. You don't care about any of those things, because if you're pushing a tower or close to a tower, then you risk dying. Oh god, wow.
Some people wow. Care absolutely awful, like...
But that doesn't mean that... The thing is that I know what you mean, but you want to assume everybody in your game is 6k.
Yeah.
Because if you don't, and you play aggressively, you play thinking, oh, these guys are bad, maybe they are bad, and maybe sometimes... Or many times, this situation is going to happen where you're supposed to die, you end up getting a double kill. Sure, that might happen, but that's only going to happen in 3K. And once you get like 100, 200 MMR higher, and you have an average MMR of 3.9K, whereas a high-level player, like there's a 4.3, 4.4K guy, he's going to destroy you every single time.
Yeah,
and then you're going to go 400 MMR back, and then you're going to go up and down and up and down. So that's what you want to get out of. You want to play better than yourself. You want to assume they are good, and you want to play according to that. Because sometimes they won't be good, but that's not really harming you that much. But if they are good, then, you know.
Yeah.
Okay, so you are going for Manta. Let's look at this one more time. I think we're trying to be part of a team fight again.
Yeah,
I don't want to just... Until you have Manta is when... If you look at this team, Pudge can't really hook you or ult you if you have Manta, because it'll take him 3 seconds to really figure out which one is real you. Same goes for Void. Void's not going to be able to ult you and make sure he's hitting the right person the first time around. 33% chance. Same goes for Tinker. Tinker lasers you. You Manta and you're not missing last hits. This guy is single target. Point being, they're mostly all single target, apart from Darkseer, but that's a different story. You can always run away from the Darkseer. Wait, I missed the part. So you TP'd mid, which was okay. You could have gone to the jungle or the lane. You were going to the lane, but then you saw this fight happening and you thought you could contribute, and then
I died. Okay.
Something I like to do when I play Alchemist as practice is play against insane bots. This idea might sound stupid, but what you want to do is not die, and it's incredibly hard because the bots will actually come and find you every single time. So you need to do is get your items and not let them kill you. And if you can, once probably going to take you several games, but once you get through the game without zero deaths, then you're ready for Alchemist in a real game.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, look, you're pushing again. Pushing the tower again. Everybody on the enemy team is missing from the map, and you're pushing the tower. Right here, you don't have Manta. Right here, Slark could have pounced you, locked you down, then Pudge didn't even need the misses, so just come, just walk up to you and rot, dismember you, and you're dead.
Yeah.
Like, you're TPing in constantly, which is okay, but you want to really take jungle farm.
Yeah.
At the end of the day. And you want a farm where you know there are no people, or the fewest amount of people.
Okay.
Of the enemy. And you don't want to stay in one place. Like, you were here, you farmed this one wave, then you came here, you farmed another wave, and now you're pushing again. You've been here for about a minute, like, roughly. Not really, about 30 seconds. But the thing is, like, their entire team knows where the Alchemist is. So if they really want to go on you, and if they decided they want to go on you, they can. They can kill you. So you've been here too long.
Yeah.
So you don't want to stay in one place too long. Yeah, you want to be just doing this, going through the jungle, take jungle farm. And now you've got Manta, so it's a different story. Now you can farm yourself, you can farm in the jungle and put the illusions out to push the lane. But if you see a team fight happening, you can join.
Yeah.
Let's see what happens. But you don't want to stand around waiting for a team fight to happen. You have travels, you want to be pushing out waves, you want to be farming jungle. But if they start pushing, like right here, they were starting to push out your tower, right? That's when, where you should have been maybe up here or down here. And do not use your Manta, because you will need Manta once you TP into the tower and start fighting. So just hold on to your Manta, and like, you don't want to be in the front lines. You're in the front lines, right? Let the Timber be in the front lines. Let the Ricky be in the front lines. I don't know. Somebody else needs to be in the front lines. You need to stay back, or not even here. Let a team fight happen, and then TP in and join the team fight.
Yeah.
Also, not ever use spells on a Snarl. Just used his
that part,
What the hell? Oh god. Dangerous. That was very, very dangerous. Yeah, the thing is here, you don't want to be chasing people down when you don't have your ult up. Like, okay, you're chasing Slark down. Most of their team is dead, but Pudge isn't going to hook you. Pudge is going to hook Slark. So that's fine, but at this point, you don't have your ult up. You were actually about to have your ult. You just took so much. Oh, okay, so you took damage from your unstable concoction, which got you just below the point, I think it was.
Yeah. So, but I could have, like, mantled that or something.
Yeah, you could have. You could have mantled that. Ricky could have smoke cloud the Tinker before he knew the Tinker. His smoke cloud. Right here, he could have smoke cloud the Tinker. You know. But. This is an ideal time for you to be pushing top tower.
Yeah.
I don't know how ideal it is, actually, because they have a Tinker. So it's not the ideal target to go on, simply because you can do that. Okay. I've kept an eye on something, and that's what I want you to focus on as well. So let's go back a little bit. Okay, let's see if it's over. So let's go back. Okay, so at 22 minutes, we are at 15,000 net worth. You've got a manta. 15,000 net worth. And then we go all the way up to. That was 22 minutes, and we're at 20. So 25 minutes, that's 6 minutes later, you've only got 1,000 extra net worth. In fact, if before this pudge kill, you were still at 15,000 net worth.
Yeah.
Well, without rounding it.
Yeah.
So literally 6 minutes later, you've only got 1,000 more gold. That's 200 GPM.
On an alc here.
Roughly. Yeah, so that's just not acceptable at all.
Yeah.
You don't want to be fighting that much. You don't want to take fights where there are no objectives. Like, fighting here, what's it going to get you? They're not pushing it. They're not going to take the tower. You're not going to take any tower over here. Absolutely useless. Fight here, they'd already taken the tower when you were fighting. Same situation. You're not taking any towers. In fact, if you'd been here, at the time where their team was here, maximum there would have been a Tinker there. And you would have made sure the Tinker isn't that part of that team fight. Maybe that makes a difference, maybe it doesn't. But if you were able to kill the Tinker, you take this tower. Even if you don't, you pressure the tower, maybe you take the tower. You do damage the tower at the very least. Then you take me to another lane, you take... you're also taking farm during that time. That fight is, like, useless. Now, many times what's going to happen, is, especially in your bracket, is your team is still going to be taking those fights, and most likely the team is going to be 4v5ing, but you can't get into the habit of taking bad fights just to win those one or two odd games, because that's not learning. That's not actually improving. You'll win those one or two games by doing that, but you're going to lose more games without realizing it. So it's a bad habit. You don't want to get into bad habits. You have to be smart about taking fights. And also, if you are going to be taking fights, then change your build. Like, that's something that I do like to do with Alt. I'll have, before I go Manta even, after my Radiance, I'll go for Invis, Shadowblade. With Shadowblade, you can take team fights. After Shadowblade, if I need more tankiness, I'll go for Silver Edge. Or if I want to disable passives, I'll go for Silver Edge. Otherwise, I'll go for Desolator. I will not go for... What's the title? Octarine.
Yeah.
So it does. Octarine doesn't really help you fight that well. Like, it will keep you alive for a while, but it's not damage. It's not damage out. So, but with Desolator, you can fight, you can take powers. Really quick.
Cool. Yeah, good to think about.
And then after that, you can go for... Octarine, because it'll get you tankier, it'll lower the cooldowns and all that good stuff. So that's fantastic. And then you can go for a Basher or Pistol. Yeah, that's good. Need to get out. Oh, God. Oh, why did you stop running? Oh, you're dead. Oh, the Bloodstone heal. The Bloodstone heal saved you.
Yeah, I know.
That was good thinking on the acid spray canceling the thing.
Yeah, I think one of my main... Obviously, there's all these sort of like efficiency and mechanical issues, but like a big thing that would help me improve so much is that if I like thought about what I was doing, because I just feel like I play the game like so, I don't think about whatever I'm doing kind of thing. Yeah. Like I'm not thinking what should I be doing now, what should I do in 2 minutes kind of thing.
Just be active is what the issue is.
Yeah.
We were 22 minutes in, this is now 7 minutes later, you've only got 3,000 x-ray.
Yeah.
Like you still don't have your next item, you know?
Yeah.
That's not something that should be happening 7 minutes later or 8 minutes later, I don't know. Well, 8 minutes later you have it, so.
Yeah, yeah.
You're just not farming enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're chasing too many kills. That's the main issue.
Yeah, yeah, that makes sense, yeah.
Like, we already established that this was a hard game, so you don't expect to get any easy wins or expect to have a huge impact in this game. So you kind of want
to... Yeah, so I should have been... Instead of, like, trying to help out, I should have been, like, farming and pushing. Yeah. Not pushing, but, like...
Yeah, push with your illusions, definitely.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Obviously, against a Tinker, that's not much. But if you do want to do something else, then you could have gone for a different kill.
Yeah.
Because this is a farming game, that's it. Like, if you'd had a Desolator and Invis, you would have actually killed the Void right here. And Tinker's coming in, you can get out. But it's okay. Alright, now you're gonna go for a deck that is just good. You've got your illusions up. Okay. If you don't have your illusions up, you wanna stay hidden away. You don't wanna join fights.
Yeah.
And you don't wanna use your illusions until you need to. Right? Like right here, you didn't need it. I think you need to wait for your illusion, using illusions until. Like you've got, you see this Lark has got Silver Edge, so you want to wait till he uses Silver Edge on you, then you use your illusions. Or if the Tinker uses Laser on you and you are right ticking or you need to right tick, then you use Manta. So don't just use Manta for the extra damage, because honestly, there's no extra damage really. Like, if you look at the actual extra damage, there's 33% extra damage, 33% damage from the Manta, which is 33% of your white damage, which is literally 33 damage. So, essentially, you're doing 66 damage with the, both the illusions combined. The radiance doesn't stack, so that's useless.
Okay.
So, 66 damage. What you're giving up for that is the potential to dispel or remove a huge debuff, I guess. Because Slark, if he breaks you, which is called break, it's not the passive. The passive is obviously really huge, but the bigger issue for you is that you're going to be doing 50% less damage. Right? So 50% less damage, you're like not doing anything because your damage is really low anyway. You're not that great. I like what you're doing with illusions. Nice.
Did that on purpose. Both. I was pretty happy about
you're
that.
You're both gonna be stunned same time. Oh, nice. That's good. It's a win scenario right there. So, need to push mid. Okay. So, I guess they're all vibes. Axe 2. That's good. Normally, I would not agree with giving an axe this early. It's not really early, it's the fact that you're not that farm yet. So, giving an axe is not that great, but because we've already established this is not your game, you want to give an axe to somebody who is going to be the main damage dealer. Actually, that's. So you ideally wanted to give the axe to Drow because
Yeah.
this guy is really under farmed right now. The timber is doing okay. Wow, never mind. He is actually quite high on the net worth, but he's not doing that great. None of your teammates are doing that great. This guy's the last recipient. So I would still give Drow the first one, and then this guy said, well, okay, it's fine. They're both fine. They're both fine. Okay, so you did not have Manta, and that's unfortunate.
Yeah, that's yeah.
But you are still gonna. Oh, God, that backfired.
Yeah, it is.
You had Manta. You had Manta right here. You had Manta.
Ah,
You would have.
that's an awareness issue.
Yeah.
If I dodged it and then killed him, it would have looked so good.
Yeah.
So, be more aware of my cooldowns.
I mean, sometimes these things happen. And then your team killed him anyway. Alright, Tinker's got laser now, axe now. That is really annoying.
Yeah.
Really, not much you can do against that except get a BKB, which you don't want to hit, but you might have to. Are you going for assault right now?
Yeah.
You know,
Or
but
Sheamus. I can't remember which.
if you look at the enemy team, Podge is not a right clicker. Disrupt, Darkseer is not a right clicker. Tinker is not a right clicker. Snarg is a right clicker, but he's got such high agility, and his like strength is he's gonna be stealing your HP with every single hit.
Yeah.
So even though sure with the assault he's doing a little bit less damage to you, but at the end of the day he's actually you're giving him more stats. So it's like a double-edged sword. It's fine, but it's not really that great. Also, the Void is really the only person that you are gonna where the salt is gonna be useful for, but the guy is like, look at his items. He's not even, I don't even know what the hell he's going for right now. So,
Yeah.
at the end of the day, if you'd gotten Heart, it would have been much better this game. If
Yeah.
you'd gotten a BKB, would have been the perfect item right here. You really need the BKB.
Yeah.
The gem on the ground.
I don't really know what I was thinking. Yeah.
Your team is all dead. You need to get out. And this is
Yeah.
very common. This is something very common. Need to help out your team. Thing is, your team is.
Yeah.
No, you were trying to get the gem though. Yeah, you're like, hey, gem. Oh, God. I thought you were going in to help out your travel, thinking that you're gonna get some kills, but I guess it was okay. You could have sent out your illusions first to check if somebody's coming close by.
Yeah.
Also, I mean, for an alchemist, bottle isn't that expensive, but you could have put the bottle a bit more secure area.
Yeah.
Not in the middle of the ground.
That's true.
Yeah. So just I'm gonna end it here. Like you didn't need to be here. If you look at this last time, they're gonna look at your death here. You're still with your team, right? You're still here with your team. You're defending a tower. Actually, you're not even with the team. You're in the front lines once again. Like
Yeah.
you don't have that. If you look at your items, your items. You got 2,300 HP, but at the end of the day, if you. I don't know. The thing with Alchemist is, even though you have a fair bit of armor as well, you've got some high HP as well, relatively high, like imagine this much HP on any of these other people. It's pretty huge. But Alchemist just dies so quickly. Every single. Look at that. You get hooked, and you die. So, I mean, Alchemist needs to be really higher up in the net worth than the rest of the people, because you've been feeding, did you feed more than one? Because you fed 4,200 net worth to somebody else, it could have been 28,000, 29,000, right? You're much higher than everybody else. Maybe you would have had a heart by now if you'd done that, or if you hadn't done that. And then maybe you wouldn't have died here, but you definitely need to not feed Axe this early on. It's not even a matter of this early on, it's a matter of not having enough farm yourself.
Yeah.
Well, and even if you do feed Axe, then what you need to do is understand that you're not tanky enough, you're not actually able to fight, you don't fight ready, unfortunately. So just push, just split push. It's done, and that's it. It's pretty amazing. It's a bow, 1,000 bow. Oh, for you. So that's not accurate, because 1,000 gold isn't that great for now. If Drow had gotten it, that would have been amazing. That's another kill. It's a gem as well. That is more than that, actually. It's like 1,500 gold. So you need to not use Manta to push at these points. So you just need to be aware of, like, right here you're pushing. Right here you're pushing, but you didn't have your Axe, your ult. So just have your ult while you're doing this. Don't use your stun unless you are trying to cancel somebody's TP or something like that. Just don't use your stun until you have your ult.
Yeah.
Oh god, you're dead again. So you were way too far in the front lines this game. Too much frontlining at the core, not recognizing that you are not recognizing that you are not strong enough to fight, not split pushing enough, standing around defending with a hero who does not want to do that. You don't want to stand around and defend, you want to be constantly doing something. If you want to throw acid spray down, throw acid spray down and then go in the back lines. If there's no other place to farm or split post, just go in the back lines and wait for something to happen. But you don't want to be standing there waiting for something to happen and be the first person to, you know, be there in the happening thing. Any questions?
Say no one's on the map,
mm-hmm.
so you can't really safely push past your T1s.
Okay,
T1s,
okay.
And your team's taken the jungle.
Yeah.
What's the plan?
Tell them to get out of the jungle. or go and farm ancients, because you can farm ancients with your assets. It depends on what. Well, if your team is in the jungle, that means they're strong enough to take jungle, which means you need to have to be by that time strong enough to be able to take ancients. So on every hero who can farm ancients, you need to be farming ancients if there's no other place to farm, or even if there is another place to farm, you want to let your team take the other place to farm, and you want to be farming the ancients, because it's all about utilizing the maximum amount of resources on the map.
Yeah.
Because in your team, I think nobody was there. Nobody could have actually taken ancients. I mean, Drow could have. What did she have? Okay, Drow couldn't have taken ancients. Drow could not have taken ancients at any point because she had no lifesteal. So yeah, really nobody on your team could have taken ancients. So you could have just been devoted to the ancients a lot more. The ancient side, at least.
Okay.